and today I'm going to be doing a review on the Maybelline Superstay Foundation. Okay, this foundation is full coverage. It is blendable. It is, you know, it is everything. It is everything that you need. I'm just kidding. But today, you guys, I'm going to be showing you guys how I like this foundation. If you are interested into seeing, you know, what the foundation looks like, what it's all about, let me know and keep watching this video. This foundation is a full coverage foundation, up to 24 hour wear, seamless matte finish, breathable and comfortable, fade and transfer resistant, oil free, doesn't clog pores, and dermatology tested. So I'm going to be trying this right out. It does have a pump on it. If you know, the other Maybelline foundations don't have pumps on them, you just have to pour. So this is a plus that this foundation has a pump on it. So we're just gonna pump it right into my hand. I did about 3 pumps. This is a full coverage foundation, so I'm going to be using my clean and damp beauty blender, Real Technique sponge, whatever you want to call it. Before we put on our foundation, we're going to be using the e.l.f. Luminous Matte Primer. And I'm just going to get that all over. I really like this primer. I've been using it for a couple of weeks now. And this primer is really luminous matte. Like, I've never heard anything like it before. And I'm really digging it. Because I do have oily skin, so this primer is actually really good for me, because I don't want to be too matte where I'm looking like, I don't know, just like dry, I don't know. This primer does give me a nice glow, even though my skin is oily. I really like it because it does mattify me too. Going with the foundation. This does look a little too light for me, maybe. But we'll see as it sinks in and oxidizes how it turns out. I do look a little orange, if not a lot orange. So I feel like I could have a darker shade in this foundation. The next shade from Warm Coconut was Mocha, but the local Ulta that I went to didn't have Mocha. They were all out, so I just got this instead, just to see if it would still work for me. But once I like conceal and bronze my face up, it'll probably like oxidize and sink into my skin. But this is really full coverage. I really, really, really like how blendable this was. I didn't have to do too many pumps of the foundation. Want to see up closer to me. Yeah, it could be a little darker just because it doesn't technically all the way match my neck, but I will put some foundation on my neck. Yeah, so this is how the foundation looks by itself, before contouring and concealing and all that other good stuff. So this is how it looks. And yes, this is in the color Warm Coconut. So maybe I'll try Mocha next time I purchase this again. If I don't, I don't know if I'm going to go back and take this back, but like this color, the color matches me a little bit, but I feel like once it like really sits in and oxidizes, it'll look good. And I know we've canceled Tarte, but I will be using Tarte Shade Tape today because I spent bread on this, and let me tell y'all, I'm going to finish the bottle. We don't have to get Tarte after this, honestly. I do like their, I do have some of their eyeshadow palettes, so that's just what it is, but I'm going to use what I bought. So we're just going to buff the concealer into my skin, to our skin, tap, 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 making tapping motions. Also, when I picked up the Superstay foundation, I also picked up the Maybelline Fit Me Loose Finishing Powder in the color Medium Deep. They also had Dark. I felt like Dark wasn't going to do it for me. So, yeah. So, we're going to take this Real Techniques Contour Brush, and we're just going to use this brush under my eyes. I really love this brush for setting my concealer with my loose powder. So, we're just going to put some of that powder on the brush, and we're just gonna pat it into our skin. I really wanted a new powder because I've been using Airspun since, you know, Jesus was born, and you know, I really needed a new powder, and I just was like, yeah, it's about that time. So I was like, yeah, let me purchase some like Maybelline. Have any other powders that you think I should try? Comment down below and let me know. I'm also gonna set my neck as well, just because we did put foundation there, so doesn't hurt. Maybelline Fit Me. This powder is mineral based formula, helps control shine and smooth skin's texture, lightweight, translucent coverage, fresh, natural look, can be used alone or over foundation. Okay, yeah, that was really nice. Hopefully they'll come out with a little bit more colors because I don't know how much this really matches my skin tone. The Black Radiance Pressed Powder in Rich Mahogany. I'm actually going to use this to warm up my face. I don't want to use this brush. I thought I did. I was going to use the brush that they give on the inside, but I really don't like using that for contour right now. So we're just going to use it. We're going to use this other Real Techniques brush. Lips, I'm going to be using the NYX Lip Suede Lip Liner in the color Club Hopper. And to top it off, I'm going to be using the Fenty Beauty Gloss, which is my favorite. And we're just going to top that off. Okay, the Maybelline Superstay Full Coverage Foundation. This is how the foundation looks after concealer and contour, a little bronze, a little eyeshadow. I hope you guys enjoy watching me put together a little look for you guys. And, you know, you can use this eye look. This could be a Valentine's Day look for you, sis. Okay? This could be a, you know, any day going outside, simple and plain. No, you know, I don't have any false lashes on right now, so, you know, just curl those lashes top and bottom, line those lips, put a little gloss on, throw a little shadow on. I use the Maybelline. I'm using all Maybelline today, almost. I'm using the City Mini palette collab with Makeup Shayla, and I use e.l.f. on my lashes. And yeah. All right, guys, bye.